you're invited. Join us in the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. All right, perfect, perfect. I got nothing. I think I've had enough, so I got nothing.
Happy Friday, Ocon. April's a busy month, so make sure you're checking out Curtis's blog for specific details, including CCLR Day on April 16th and prom. Prom is May 4th at the Mitchell Domes in Milwaukee. Ticket sales close on Monday, April 8th at 11:59 p.m. No exception, so make sure to purchase your tickets today. Get your prom tickets before the window closes on Monday. And speaking of deadlines, we have two big ones for next Friday, April 12th. Any seniors planning to submit graduation speeches have until Friday. Write your speeches and get it to Mr. Curtis no later than Friday. Information about auditions will follow. And link crew applications are also due by Friday, April 12th. Please note there are mandatory training days over the summer. You must be available both days in order to be eligible to be a link leader. Any sophomores or juniors interested should complete the application and submit. No late applications will be accepted. And in club news today, Science National Honor Society brings us Science Fact of the Week. Did you know that scientists have discovered ice-spewing volcanoes on the dwarf planet Pluto? If you didn't, you do now. Thank you, SNHS. And spring sports are in full swing, starting with baseball. They're at the Dockhound Stadium at 4:30 playing Watertown. Boys lacrosse take on Maguanago Indians tonight at 7:30. Girls soccer's away at Madison La Follette at 7 o'clock. Saturday's also a busy sports day. Boys and girls track are headed to UW Parkside for an indoor meet. Girls lacrosse takes on USM at 12:30. Boys lacrosse is headed to Wauwatosa West for their game at 12:30. Softball's headed to Milton at 1:15 for a tournament. Wow, lots to do. Let's go, Ocon, and good luck to all of our teams. Up next, we have Braden with this weekend's weather forecast.
All right, guys. So we have. So thankfully, the winter weather is gone. It doesn't look like it's going to come back anytime soon, as our temperatures are going to climb, and we are going to make it into the 60s by Monday and Tuesday. So today, a high of 44, and we are going to see the clouds clear throughout the day. Tomorrow, a high of 50 and mostly sunny skies. Sunday, a high of 46. Unfortunately, rain showers are looking likely throughout the day. Monday is the solar eclipse, and I'm going to give more details on that in just a second. A high of 61, and unfortunately for us here, we are looking at some rain showers, and we may or may not see a break in the clouds for the eclipse. And then Tuesday, a high of 60 and partly cloudy skies. So for the eclipse on this next Monday, April 8th, a total solar eclipse is going to occur, which means that the moon is going to block the sun in the middle of the day, and it's going to cast a shadow across the United States. So for us here in southeastern Wisconsin, the peak is going to be around 2:08 p.m. And for southeastern Wisconsin, we are going to be 80 to 90% blocked by the sunlight, which does sound like a lot at first. However, it is going to be a day and night, or a night and day difference between what we see here and what the path of totality looks like. So it's only going to get a little darker here. And that's why I highly recommend traveling to the path of totality, because the next one won't be until 2044. So if you do have plans to watch the solar eclipse, make sure that you wear your glasses and make sure that you stay updated with the latest forecast and cloud forecast to make sure that wherever you're watching, there is going to be a good sight of the eclipse. Like a.
All right. Thank you, Braden. Have a great weekend, everyone. We'll see you back on Monday for another update on the eclipse. And don't forget to follow us on YouTube at OHS Digital Productions and Instagram at OHS_RCC. As always, share your news with our team at rcc@osd.org. And here's Mr. Curtis with the joke of the day.
And just to clarify, we're allowed a couple snow days a year and one power outage day a year. So the sun outage on Monday, we don't have a day for that. We took that before break. That was the plan. Too bad. All right. Why don't snakes eat soup? Snakes are weird, but they don't eat soup. How's it going? All right. How's the best day of your life, raccoons? Good luck this weekend, everyone.